We were looking for a word feedback, and we said a feedback amplifier which is of interest to us. We have an amplifier which is say has a gain of AOL and it is called open loop gain, and it gives you a voltage output of X0 when an input of XS is given or XI is given. And we also said that the part of X0 is returned to input and mixed with the signal to form the new XI. Okay. And if XF is in opposite phase to XS, that is the input signal is reduced by XF feedback signal, then XI will reduce, and if XI reduces, X0 will reduce. And if X0 reduces, the beta X0 which is the feedback signal also reduces. So XS minus XF will now increase and get a new XI, which when amplified by AOL will get a new X0 which is slightly larger, and this feedback will finally settle to 1 XF, XS and X0 values. So negative feedback essentially stabilizes the gain X0 by XS. This is the purpose of any feedback amplifier. I want to stabilize the gain, fixed gains. So if there is any noise or anything which is putting in this, and if I have a feedback ratio, then I will see that the gain stabilizes. Okay, that is the purpose of negative feedback. That is what we started with. We looked into a few things. We talked about A beta, we talked about this. We also looked into few properties of negative feedback. One of them we said about gain desensitivity, and we said the closed loop gain is A0 upon 1 plus A0 beta. Now please remember, if you are not working with Sedra Smith, many books this value will come X0 1 minus A0 beta. Don't get worried too much. What essentially they are saying, that the expression which I derived in getting this expression, I said XI is XS minus XF. So I already thought it is a negative feedback. What they are saying is they are actually giving it this plus. Okay. And because of that they will get a 1 minus A beta values there. But essentially they are saying whenever XF is negative, put a minus sign correspondingly. Okay. So beta will become minus and 1 plus A beta will again become as is there. So that is the trick of the trade. So if some books you are following in which they are writing 1 minus A beta, they are essentially using this plus with no sign of XF right now. But if it is a negative feedback, it will subtract, and if it subtracts, then that 1 plus A beta term will appear. Okay, so we said that if we have a feedback network, the closed loop gain with feedback means the change in such gain with reference to its initial gain will be proportional to 1 upon A0 beta times D0 by D0. That means any change in this, the closed loop gain will be much smaller by 1 upon A0 beta factor. That means it is desensitized the gain variation. That is what I was saying, stabilizing the gain. DA0 by A0 is the sensitivity of A0. If this sensitivity has to be reduced, and if I divide by some fixed factor, then the closed loop gain essentially shows less sensitivity compared to A0. That is the purpose of negative feedbacks. This is what we did last time. We also said by same logic we figured out that if there is a bandwidth and if there is a pole, midband upon something like this, and we finally said in a closed loop gain the bandwidth will also increase by 1 plus AM beta times omega 0. That means the increase of bandwidth was essentially occurring because of what? Because the closed loop gain was lower than the open loop gain. AOL was higher than ACL. We reduced that by 1 upon A beta factor, and because of that by same factor the gain bandwidth also increased. Is that point clear, that the bandwidth increases by same ratios? Because what is what, why it should be of same? Because gain bandwidth for an amplifier will still remain constant unless transistors are changed. Is that clear? So since we are not changing anything else, so if the gain reduces by 1 upon 1 plus A beta, the bandwidth is proportionally increased by that much amount. This is the trick of increasing the bandwidth whenever you are looking for a larger bandwidth amplification. Where do you think you need larger bandwidth amplifiers? For example, of course, these are not the amplifiers which we use there, but let us say we are using a mobile applications, mobile systems in which there are amplifiers. Of course, they are at very high frequency. So is television signals, both video and audio. They are at 62 megahertz to 67 megahertz, 5 megahertz bandwidth. In case of GSM, it may be almost around a gigahertz bandwidth. So which means I want an amplifier which has a large bandwidth, but I may not have larger gains at larger bandwidths. This has to be understood. So in many cases, I do not really need gain of 100, I need gain of 10, 15. So, but I need larger bandwidths. So feedback is one way to improve the bandwidths, correspondingly reducing the open loop gains. Okay. This is universal and there is nothing to do with any of the kind of amplifier, everything. Feedback always reduces the gain, negative feedback, I must clarify, negative feedback always reduces the gain. Why positive feedback, what will do? In fact, it will gain will start enhancing, or the output will start enhancing, because every time you give a feedback, input rises, so output rises. Part of reason output is further fed back as a larger feedback, so further output, so it is called growth functions. Okay. So now you can understand, if I have a system in which I have two kinds of feedbacks, one which is negative feedback, one is which is positive feedback, and I adjust their feedback such that the net feedback is zero. Such systems will be called oscillators. Okay, we will see what exactly are oscillators. Okay, so it must grow, but it should not grow randomly, so it should reduce some way, and that kind of system will follow a law which we will see using this theorem itself later, called Barkhausen's criteria. Okay, and we will see if the Barkhausen's criteria is not violated or is violated, oscillations damps down, okay, or infinite growths can start in either case. We also, I think last time showed you, there are four kinds of possible feedback amplifiers. The mixing is the word used at the input, that is the feedback signal mixes with input signal, and sampling is the word used, part of the output is fed back, what is the part coming from there, okay, that part is essentially called sampling. I have a output, part of it is fed back, okay, so that is called sampling. So I can either have sampling done on currents or I can have sampling done on voltages. Same is, I can have mixing of voltages at the input source, or I can have current at the same node which may also mix with the current at the input. So essentially there are four possible amplifiers in which the input signals and feedback signals are of this kind, output is of this kind, and mixing can be series or shunt. Depends on the way we define, we will show you that little later. And these amplifiers are also therefore classified as voltage amplifiers, in which there is a series mixing, voltage is series mixed, okay, and the output is sampled also voltage wise, okay, and therefore it is called voltage output divided by voltage inputs. Such an amplifiers are voltage amplifiers. Please remember, all amplifiers can be called voltage amplifiers in the end. Why? Even if output is the current, if I put it across a load resistance, it will create a voltage at the output. So do not think that I am meant by current amplifier means only I am looking current. I am saying current will enhance and correspondingly IR drop may also enhance. But the gain essentially I will define only with the increase of what a relationship I am taking. Okay. So one will be current amplifier, one will be if the input is voltage and output is current, then we say it is a transconductance. If the voltage input is current and output is voltage, we say it is trans resistance amplifier. So we four amplifiers, I repeatedly saying that all amplifiers can be current amplifiers or voltage amplifiers per se, that is output to input ratio, you can choose anything you like, but the basic amplification is voltage to current or voltage to voltage or current to voltage is what we are saying by these four terms. We will see this now when we start having an example. we said there can be four possible mixing and shunt sampling. Here is two kinds of mixing we showed. I think instead of this I can directly show you the better ones. I mean they are separated, now I mixed both of them. So you can see I have a voltage amplifier which has a voltage gain. So if it receives an input Vi, please remember it receives an input Vi here, okay, and the output of an amplifier is V0, output of an amplifier is V0, this is an input, this is an output. So if there is no feedback, what will be the gain of this transistor, this amplifier? V0 by Vi is always called open loop gains, is that correct? V0 by Vi is the open loop gain, is that word clear to you? Because feedback has been taken away, then we say whatever is received at the, in this case what may happen, Vs may become ratio of Rs by Ri plus whatever into Vi, but Vi is the real input to a transistor and therefore the gain is Vs by Vo by Vi, okay, and that is called, without feedback whatever gain occurs we say it is open loop. In the feedback one can see from here I have taking a voltage across RL, okay, these two terminals are voltage, I am picking voltage across the output load RL and I am passing that voltage across a feedback network which has a gain factor of beta. Since it is a voltage, it will give beta times V0 will be output somewhere here, beta times V0 will be output here, which I defined as Vf, beta times V0 is the sampled output. So the what kind of sampling I did here, this is my V0 and I am putting a shunt across the load, I am picking the voltage. So this is a shunt connection. What is series connection? Series to the, this will be series connection, across is shunt connection. So I am picking across outputs, so it is a shunt connection here, so it is called shunt sampled, is that correct? This has shunt sampling. This receives a voltage Vf which is beta times V0 and gives you a series voltage to the signal. Vf is equivalently saying there is a voltage source here as if here in series to the signal, is that correct? So how I am mixing? Series mixing I am doing, and since I am doing a series mixing and I am putting voltage plus voltage, minus or plus sign correspondingly, then I say it is mixed series way at the input, is that clear? So input is also voltage, output is also voltage, feedback is also voltage, such amplifiers will be voltage amplifiers, is that also called series shunt amplifiers. What are these called? Why it is called series shunt? The mixing is in series and sampling is at the output is shunt, so it is called series shunt amplifiers, okay. If I am looking for shunt series amplifier, then I do little trick, I say okay, the series connection at the output can only be taken if there is a current which can be input in series, voltages there is no voltage source except coming from the amplifier. So what we say, if there is a current amplifier whose output is I0 passing through RL, in normal case this will be connected, okay. So what will be actual voltage drop to you? I0 minus I0 RL, minus is because of the phase shifts. So V0 is still output if you need, is that clear? But what is real output for this amplifier? I0 is the real output of this amplifier. So I0 by II, if I use it, then I say it is current amplifier, okay. But the feedbacks we start looking, if this is my current and series to this, part of this current is fed back to a network which gives me beta times I0 as my feedback current. Now this current I connect it to a node, this node for example. Then I say if I had to connect it at a node, then I say it is a shunt. Any node, what is shunting across? At any node, if you put a current, you say you are actually shunting at that point. Is that correct? Shunt means what? Between two nodes. So I am adding a current and ground is the other side. So I am actually putting a current at a node, then I say it is getting into that. Okay. So this, you can see the way I have fed. I have connected, which is the path for feedback current? It goes like this and comes like this. Is that correct? It goes like this and comes like this. Okay. So this is essentially, we say, shunting the current at the input. Remember, what is being entered here? Current. This is a current source. I am entering a current here. That is getting modified by this current source, which is feedback current. Okay. That, what is the II current will be here? Can you tell me now if this is opposite phase? IS minus IF will be the actual current II flowing inside the amplifier. Is that correct? If this current is leaving, this current is entering. So this current is IS minus IF is whatever is going to the amplifier. So if IF increases, what does that mean? That is, feedback is larger. What does it mean? II is smaller. If II is smaller, I0 is smaller. If I0 is smaller, IF will become smaller next time. If IF reduces, II increases. So I0 increases, and this will, in a loop kind, it will start reducing slowly, slowly, and finally it will settle to a value in which I0 by II is the gain of the amplifier and fixed IF will start flowing. Is that correct? This is the purpose of negative. Is that point clear? What is negative feedback? If it is above, it reduces. If it is below, it pushes up. Okay. Is that point clear? Why it stabilizes? If that current increases, then the feedback will reduce it, negative feedback. If it reduces, the feedback is lower and therefore input rises, so output rises. So it settles itself to a value which is essentially called shunt inputs, shunt currents here, and currents are series way picked up from the output. Such amplifiers are called shunt series amplifiers. By same logic, we can do the other two. This is very interesting. Both two, you can see from here, this is scratch part. I am taking a same sampling, current sampling, that is I0 amplifier. Output is what? What is output of this amplifier? Current, I0. Please remember, I kept on telling I0 into RL is going to give you V0 anyway. Is that point clear to you? So voltage can always be picked up by any current outputs. Okay. But this amplifier is essentially has I0 and II is the current flowing here. Okay. Voltage is the voltage across this amplifier is VI. So what we are now saying, that whatever is I0 is proportional to VI by what factor? What is the gain here? Transconductance, current by voltage. So such an amplifier is a transconductor. Output is current, input is voltage. So current by voltage is transconductance. Our input is voltage, output is current. So we have a transconductance amplifier, and it is given by term GM. Okay. Though in our case we keep calling A everywhere, but as a can be GM, A can be RM, A can be current, AI, it can be AV. But in our definition of feedback, we keep A constant. Okay. Is that point clear? How many A's can be? A can be AV, A can be AI, A can be GM, A can be RM. But essentially, there are four separate amplifiers. Is that correct? Now, in this case, beta, this whatever is voltage across I am creating. So network is such that I put a series voltage in series to the source. Then whatever this voltage is negative to this, correspondingly VI will change and correspondingly I0 will change. Part of it feedback, again it is a negative feedback circuit. Input is at series, output is at series. Is that correct? Current is also in series and voltage is also in series. This is called series-series amplifier, or also called transconductance amplifier. By same logic, both sides are shunts. This is voltage, this is current. Current, voltage divided by current is resistance. So So these amplifiers are shunt, which are essentially called trans resistance amplifiers. Is that correct? So feedback allows you to create 4 possible amplifiers. Okay. Now, why are we want to do? Because many of the circuits which we have done earlier, without knowingly that there was a feedback, you will see suddenly, for example, a source follower or an emitter follower, which will take an example later. Which kind of amplifier do you see it is? It is a voltage is being sampled and voltage is in series to the input itself. RE is common between the output and input. Part of the voltage is picked up across RE. It may be 1 here because the same is fed back. Beta can be unity in that case. So whatever is received at the output is also a part of input. RE is common to both sides and series of that. So we say it is a voltage, I mean you can see it is a series at the input, and what is at the output? Series. So they, we can similarly, if I have a capacitance or a resistance between gate and the drain, is that correct? That will be a shunt because output is voltage but input is at that a node. So we say it is a transconductance amplifier, trans resistance amplifier. So each name we may not have given there, but the amplifiers we have already seen them. Is that correct? Whenever there is a connection between output and input by any impedance, whether it is resistance or capacitance or RC networks, these will form a feedback amplifier. Is that correct? The nomenclatures we are now defining with the word feedback, bada naam deke, aisa nahi hai. We have already done those amplifiers. Like for example, the common source amplifier, common source amplifier with source degeneration. The feedback is from where? From the load side, is that correct? So the but the feedback is in from the this side, you are feeding it back. So one is current and one is voltage. Okay. So now that we have already done those amplifiers, okay, but we have never named up which kind of amplifiers we are using, because there we always say we are looking into voltage by voltage. All amplifier here also we can look as a voltage by voltage. After all, a current source is equivalent to a voltage source and a series resistance in Thevenin's way. A Norton source is equivalent to a Thevenin source. So essentially we are not actually trying to say we are doing something great. All that we are saying, we are doing more generalized way of doing it, and all other cases are more specific cases of that. Okay. That is what you have to say, but the advantage what we get, probably there we did not. Do you remember in common source amplifier with source degeneration or common emitter with emitter degeneration, what is the gain? The load divided by the degenerated resistance. Typically all other factors are small. So RL by RE or RL by RS, that is what we said. What is the advantage we said there? The gain has reduced, but it is independent of transistor stabilized. The word we did not say very specifically that time. Stabilized, is that correct? Yes, feedback stabilizes the gain and gain reduced, is that correct? So please, why I am bringing this fact again, just to tell you that we have already done most of the amplifiers in some way or the other. Many of them were feedback amplifier, and that part we did not care because we solved a Kirchhoff equations, is that correct? If it is a feedback, so dono ka do equation likh diye. So we actually took care of feedback without actually telling it is a feedback. Whenever between drain and gate we connected, it was a feedback, output input was connected, or between collector and base we connected, we were connecting it, is that correct? So without telling you that this was a feedback amplifier, we solved as a Kirchhoff law without thinking, because then I do not have to think anything. So what is this feedback theory is trying to tell? I need not do all that analysis for all of them. I can do something interesting. I can calculate the open loop gain by and show how to get it. I can calculate A beta for that, okay, and then I directly can write A beta upon 1 plus A upon 1 plus A beta is feedback gain, and I can find input impedance and output impedance, okay. That is something what I want to do quickly once I know that. But otherwise, even if you do not know any feedback, we were anyway solving the circuit, is that correct? So do not think that this is trying to do something over and above that. It is only trying to generalize the same thing which we did earlier, okay. their individual case we solve here, you say you don't have to solve, you particular case is a specific case of this case, okay. So this is what I keep telling you, that the books do not want to tell this, they have a separate chapter telling as if this is an individual extraordinary work we are doing. No, it's not actually. Another thing which feedback provides us is something called, a word which we call nonlinear distortions. कोई आप मुझे बता सकते हैं कि नॉन लीनियर डिस्टॉर्शन का मीनिंग क्या होता है? या फर्स्ट लेट्स फॉरगेट डिस्टॉर्शन वर्ड, लीनियर एंड नॉन लीनियर क्या टर्म होगी? इफ आई हैव ए फंक्शन एफ एक्स एंड इफ इट इज लीनियर, इट मे हैव ए कोएफिशिएंट ए जीरो, ओके, इट्स ए लीनियर सिस्टम. बट इफ आई हैव ए टर्म, it has become non-linear. Is that correct? Higher terms to or be, that is non-linearity will keep on increasing, okay, as we get cube term, four term, fifth term. But if x is your signal, sinusoid signal, let us say vi is a sin omega t. So what is vi square? A square sin square omega t. साइन स्क्वायर ओमेगा टी को कुछ और एक्सपैंड कर सकते हैं क्या? साइन टू ओमेगा टी इज हाउ मच? वन माइनस टू साइन स्क्वायर ओमेगा टी टू ओमेगा टी, इज दैट करेक्ट? सॉरी, इट इज आइदर वे. सो व्हाट डज दैट मीन? स्क्वायर टर्म्स विल बी गिव व्हाट टर्म्स टू अस? द ओमेगा टी टर्म्स इज कमिंग फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट वन, बट टू ओमेगा टी टर्म्स विल कमिंग फ्रॉम द स्क्वायर टर्म्स, ओके, and higher order terms will give higher order frequency. So these are called harmonics, okay. Omega is called fundamentals, any number proportional to this omega, 2 omega, 3 omega, these are called harmonic. But whenever harmonics are present, output will also show you corresponding those frequency outputs. V0 will also have a components of 2 omega t, 3 omega t apart from omega t, omega. What does that mean? In real life, I will see to it that I receive power only at omega, my fundamental. I may do some what we call tuned circuit there, so which will pick up only signal at omega. But what is it means then? That the power which has or energy which has gone to 2 omega, 3 omega or n omega, I have lost. So the efficiency of an amplifier will keep reducing as non-linearity starts increasing. Is that correct? Because you will actually not get equivalent voltage if you would have got a linearity. Some part of it is as if is lost by you. Is that correct? So if you see, this is what theory I was telling, and you can now see very easily. See, there is a V0 Vn characteristics from some value say here to here, 40 to 40 volt millivolt, it is linear. Output is minus 5 to plus 5. Yeah, it's not necessarily, this is from op amp. So one typical values I chose from an op amp. Okay. So we say, let's say this linearity has a gain of 100. Okay. Any gain can be assumed just for the heck of it. So if Vin is less than 40 millivolt or greater, actually minus 40, from here to here, one can see that output will be proportional to Vin, 100 times Vin, is that correct? But if you look for little term which is ahead of this, where non-linearity has started, it is not, maybe that does not, cube terms are smaller there, that is A2 coefficients are smaller, but at least square terms have will appear, because it is not linear, so second term to aa gaya aapke paas. So if we say V0 is 100 within this range plus minus, and the second term will now V0, at least abhi ek taraf ka hai, dekho square mein to koi farak nahi padega, Vn minus 0.04 square, and as I just now said, when I square the inputs, I will see in outputs also 2 omega 3 equivalent terms now. So we say from 40 volt to 60 millivolt, we may say only second harmonic appears, that is the dominant other frequency than omega is 2 omega. But if we go beyond 60 millivolt, the gain is really becoming flatter now, which means there will be more cube and maybe fourth order, fifth order terms will also start appearing. That means gain will start reducing drastically. So beyond this, we may say voltage become fixed to 5 volt maximum. Does that occur in op-amp? If op-amp has a power supply of minus 5 plus 5, it saturates at plus 5 or it saturates at minus 5. So I just that's what I said, that typically op-amp characteristics I chose to explain my term. So I want to see that if there is a non-linearity, how much non-linearity is tolerable to you. So we want to see, since our swing is now 40 millivolt only, minus 40 plus 40, but I have a signal which is 100 millivolt, then what will happen, where the output will go? Fixed 5 volt, nothing else can be done now, okay. But I want actually linearity there, okay. So one method of improving the linearity of a nonlinear system is to give a negative feedback. Is that correct? So what is the advantage of negative feedback will be seen, that if I give a negative feedback, but at what cost I will get it? Lower gain. Abhi kitna gain hai? 100, okay. If this is my normal amplifier, 100 wala, okay, ye wala, 5 volt se minus 5, yadi main values humko fir dikha raha hu, yadi maine feedback diya, to main around, yadi feedback gain 10 bhi hai, to 450 millivolt to 450 millivolt tak main isko linearize kar dunga, par gain kitna kiya maine, 1/10, 100 ka 10 kar diya maine. So feedback lagane se, I have reduced the gain 10 times, okay, but what did I achieve? The input signal range has now increased by 10 times, okay, 450 or 400 millivolt to 4. So large signal amplification yadi karna hai, to kya karna padega? Feedback amplifiers use karna padega. So do you know now I have reduced nonlinear distortion in this? Why do I say I have reduced now? Because now up to even 450 millivolts or minus 450 millivolt, there is no nonlinearity. And if there is no nonlinearity in that range, then we say there is no distortion in that range. Is that clear? If the gain linearity is up to higher values of signal, there is no nonlinearity. So by actually providing you a feedback, what did I achieve? Linearity was improved by me by order, because the gain I reduced by an order. Is that correct? So this is another advantage I see. Whenever I have a large signal amplification desired, what does that mean? Where does this large signal amplification will be required? First stage of a normal amplifier may not be a feedback amplifier. Aapne pehle 5 millivolt hai, 100 ka gain hai, to 500 millivolt output aa jayega, hai na? To aap input aur bhi kam karna padega. पर नेक्स्ट समझो आपका 400 मिलीवोल्ट आउटपुट आया है फर्स्ट स्टेज से, तो नेक्स्ट स्टेज को तो फिर वो करने ही नहीं देगा, क्योंकि वो तो सैचुरेशन में पहले पहुंचा देगा. बट आई वांट टू एम्पलीफाई स्टिल दिस सिग्नल व्हिच इज हायर वोल्टेजेस. सो व्हाट शुड आई डू देन? आई पुट अ फीडबैक फॉर द सेकेंड स्टेज, रिड्यूस द गेन बट स्टिल बूस्ट दैट. इज दैट करेक्ट? बाय इंक्रीजिंग माई लीनियरिटी रेंज टू हायर इनपुट रेंज, I have now been able to actually have a two-stage amplifier with a larger outputs available for inputs which are larger now, okay. This is the advantage of having nonlinear distortion reductions. Is that correct? Yes. Saturation is the ultimate, it may be 100 polynomials nonlinearity or 1000 polynomials. Is that correct? But even at the, when the linearity starts bending down and signal go, I mean output start bending, there is a non-linearity term has appeared, and that means the first order term ke saath second order terms aa gayi, aur thoda bend hua to third bhi aa rahe honge. So at the edge also, if you have a normal amplifier, theek hai, ye 40 ke bajaye 45 tak nahi dega, usse kya farak pada, mujhe to 500 chahiye tha. Oh, this is just to give an example, young man. Wherever it will start bending, and if the, why so you say why feedback 10? I am only trying to say you that by increasing the, if I want increase input range, I can actually put a feedback to reduce the gain and then increase the linearity. this is the purpose. That means at least in this range linearity is maintained by me, therefore nonlinear distortion does not occur in this case. In this case, even here itself I have a nonlinearity starts, okay. So my input swing is very low. So if my input swings are higher, then what do I do? And I want linearity. Normally in what we call tuned amplifiers, which are different kinds, we are just now looking for amplifiers called class A. But if you are looking for amplifiers like class C or class D or class E, class F, we are not interested in linearity anyway there. Is that clear? Since we are not talking, please remember there are class A, class B, class C, class D, class E, class F. Six kinds of class of amplifier also exist. All class A amplifiers are essentially linear amplifiers. Is that correct? Output is directly proportional to inputs. So all the amplifiers so far we are talking is class A. All that we said, if I want in a class A amplification in which I do not want distortion, I can put a feedback. Is that correct? But not every amplifier need be work. There is also another in between called class AB, okay. So I think maybe at the end of the day I may show you quickly what are these classes and where do they use. All radars, for example, will be using either the class C if it is sinusoid. If it is a pulse transforms, then you will have class D, class E or class F amplifiers, like all mobile systems, mobile transmissions which is running at 890 megahertz to above, or Bluetooth running at 2 to 4 gigahertz, there we are using class F, class E amplifiers. Is that clear? But there we are not worried about that, we are actually using nonlinearity. Is that correct? So it is not my contention that nonlinearity is always bad. Is that point clear to you? What I am saying, in a class A amplifier, if I have to improve the input range for distortion free input range, then I must put feedback. Is that point clear? Okay. So having told you this, let us do something more, okay. So here is something which I will like you to, so this is a graph which is called signal flow graph, okay. This is only shown for this circuit, but can be shown for any circuit. What is say, this is my amplifier, okay. This is my signal in Vs, input to A0, the output of this is some Vin, and from Vin to input of signal V, will say why it is Vin dash a hat, okay. Then there is the amplifier A0, and then this another term we say, let us say all distortions are taken care as a noise at the output, okay. All distorted outputs are taken as an equivalent of a VD noise at that point. So we say whatever is coming from amplifier will be added by this VD. Is that correct? But if you have a feedback here, directly it will come as a VD. But if you have a feedback like this, one can say V0 is not only AF VS, but plus VD times divided by 1 plus A0 beta. You can do this analysis as we did earlier, okay. So what does this essentially means? Now the noise factor is actually reduced by 1 plus T factor. Is that correct? Gain of course has also reduced. Doing so, earlier it would have been A, now it is AF. But by doing that, I have actually seen that the distortion outputs or noise outputs also get reduced by 1 plus A beta times. So one can say this term being very, very small, output is proportional to input. That is what the graph I was trying to show. Looking at the Vs to Vin, there is no any network. Why this one has been put here? Because there is a direct transmission here, okay. But if there is a RS or some combination, this itself will have some gain there. Less than 1, but RS upon something by this. So this yahan se yahan aane tak abhi to gain 1 hai. So usko gain likhte 1, okay. We also right now do not tell you, but why I want hats, I will come back when I draw feedback full amplifiers. From Vin to Vin hat, there is no change, it is same connection. So we say it has also a gain of 1. Vin hat goes through an amplification of A to get to a V0. at this point we have a distortion through a sigma, and we say all of it is connected at the output. If there is a network here also, it may further reduce like in feedbacks. So here is V distortion, and all of this through a gain of beta is fed back to Vn. Is that correct? Ye dekho, yahan se Vs se Vn aya, Vn se Vn hat aya, Vn hat se V0 ka pehla wala aya, yahan par hi Vd bhi mila, aur ye yahan se output through a gain of beta is returned to this Vn. This point, whatever I am showing here, this has a gain of 1, this has a gain of 1, this has a gain of beta times whatever it is. So we say whatever amplifier we say, we can represent that circuit by a signal flow graph. Is that correct? Iska arrow kaisa hoga? Achha, ye another thing, there is a arrow you have to show everywhere. What does that arrow means? Signal path going from where to where? From this node to this node, signal is going in this direction. So this node to this node, signal has gone from this direction. Okay. From here it has gone to Vn hat with a gain of 1, so it has gone to this node which is Vn hat node by gain of 1. So here also I must have an arrow. From Vn hat there is an amplifier to go to V0, so I have gone to V0 which has a gain of A. At the same point I have a distortion input with a gain, assuming here say yahan aane mein 1 hi hai, same input wahan aa raha hai, so it is this point, and from here I am feeding back beta gain ke sath. So any amplifier circuit can be represented by signal flow graph. Is that correct? So bahut bar aapko kya hai exam jab problem, not exam, but they may not show you all that. They say okay, this is the signal flow graph for the system design and this and this for it. Okay, but essentially it is this system. Please remember, there is nothing great in signal flow graph. Okay, all that it does, it's larger such a blocks of circuits can be represented by only lines, and they can also represent the function going through. These are called signal flow graphs. Is that correct? Now why do we are we interested in signal flow graph? Itna trivial bhi nahi na, sirf dikhane ke liye nahi kiya hua na. So word lagaya humne graph. Tab aap, you will know it. Since I have a graph, I can manipulate it better than anything. Okay, and then I can, my solutions will be faster, and then only I have to solve smaller parts. Okay, so signal flow graph do help us at the end to give a smaller circuit solutions. Okay, therefore signal flow graph theory is relevant. Okay, the most important thing in a feedback amplifier is feedback gain. But that smaller value, we already said A by A B 1 plus A beta, gain reduce ho jata hai. But doing this, do we achieve something else or do we lose something else? I call it achieve or call it lose. So we say okay, the other two parameters of interest in an amplifier, one is gain, of course also a bandwidth. Right now please remember, I am not talking of bandwidth part. This will do separately. What bandwidth, we did say that bandwidth increases. Okay, but we will actually see Bode's plots of feedbacks and how do they change. Okay, but as said, right now we are not talking of bandwidth. So what two other parameters of an amplifier of interest to us is the input resistance and the output resistance. So we say start looking into it, because of feedback, does it happen differently then? So we figured out, yes, feedback has also influences on the RI and RO both sides, R out both sides. So we see what are in four cases which we had, one series mixing, shunt mixing, series sampling, shunt sampling. So all charo case mein RI RO kya honge, we will like to see. Okay, so we said okay, let's look at, this is a normal amplifier. Okay, for the simplicity right now I may neglect RS. We can always add this Vs can be modified by something into this and use a new source, Thevenin source. So right now we say Vs is the source, and this is beta times V0. This is series mixing. What thing I am talking about? series mixing, voltage is in series to the signal, and the input resistance is seen before the feedback, that is after the source, after this is Ri will be seen. Please remember Rs is not part of Ri, is that correct? Rs is not part of Ri. So whatever voltage actually I am looking at here is I am calling Vs, is that correct? Though it is, it may be ratio of something, but essentially I am saying, because I am only interested here, okay. So this is my source, this is my feedback which is reducing Vs because it is a negative feedback, and I want to know what is the input resistance here. Without this feedback, how much is our input resistance? Ri, there is nothing else. If I put a voltage source there, V bias, there is nothing to see about. There is only one resistor sitting here. If I see it, only I see that, nothing else I see, okay. Is that correct? But something else I may see. This Ri may include the bias resistor network or any other thing which you say may include in this Ri, but for me it is only Ri, is that correct? So I am seeing here Rn is only Ri, okay. But if I have feedback, then I want to know, I say AF, which is the gain, which is V0 by Vs, AL by A beta, which is A, this is our feedback gain for an amplifier. We say Ri is Vs hat, that is the voltage at this point, okay, divided by Ii, which is my, in the first case, this is Vs hat I put it, so it is Ri. With the new one, I find RIF is Vs divided by current. Is that correct? What is the resistance seen here? Voltage divided by current. Dekho fir se, ye voltage hai yahan par, ye current hai. Is that correct? So Vs divided by Ii is the resistance seen by the source into the circuit. Is that correct? But now I see this Ii current, it is not same as, it is now getting as if modified by feedback. If that is not there, Ii will be same as the old current, okay. But if there is a feedback, I now see Ii is nothing but Vi divided by Ri. Is that clear? Vi divided by Ri. But this I know Ri, Vs divided by Vi, Vs divided by Vi. Now we say Vs, you can see here, Vi plus Vf is Vs, this voltage drop plus this voltage drop is this, Vs is this voltage plus this voltage, is that correct? So Vi plus Vf is Vs, which is essentially Vi, and what is Vf? Beta times V0, but what is V0? A beta times Vi, abhi dikha hai na upar se, A beta times Vi. So we say Vs is nothing but 1 plus A beta times Vi, substitute here, so I get RIF, which is the feedback input resistance, as Ri times 1 plus A beta or 1 plus T. So kya badha ke kam hua? Badh gaya, na? So this series mixing hai, तो इनपुट रेजिस्टेंस बढ़ जाता है, नेगेटिव फीडबैक. कंसेप्चुअली क्या बोल सकते हैं, क्यों बढ़ा? व्हाट इज द करंट इन द सर्किट डिसाइडेड बाय द वोल्टेज डिवाइडेड बाय रेजिस्टेंस इज द करंट. इन द फीडबैक द वोल्टेज रिड्यूसेस, दैट्स व्हाई नेगेटिव फीडबैक में वोल्टेज रिड्यूसेस अक्रॉस दिस. इफ इट रिड्यूसेस द करंट ऑल्सो रिड्यूसेस. रेजिस्टेंस में क्या होता है, करंट कम हो गया तो क्या होता है, रेजिस्टेंस बढ़ जाता है. वीएस तो फिक्स रखा है ना आपने. सो व्हाट एसेंशियली फीडबैक इज डूइंग, इट इज रिड्यूसिंग द करंट इन द इनपुट मेश, इज दैट करेक्ट? एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दैट द इनपुट रेजिस्टेंस इज दैट फिजिकल वर्ड क्लियर? बिकॉज दैट रिड्यूसेस, करंट रिड्यूसेस, दैट मीन्स द नेट रेजिस्टेंस इंक्रीजेस, एंड द फीडबैक एसेंशियली इज टेलिंग द इनपुट रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ ए सीरीज connected at the input mixing will always be higher than. कौन से सर्किट में हमने ये Ri ज़्यादा देखा था? किसी भी emitter circuit में यदि resistance है, ओके, तो इनपुट में कितना दिखेगा? यदि बाइपोलर ट्रांजिस्टर है तो बीटा टाइम्स आर आई विल बी रिफ्लेक्टेड इनसाइड, इज दैट करेक्ट? बीटा टाइम्स आर आई विल बी रिफ्लेक्टेड, सो आर पाई प्लस बीटा टाइम्स आर आई आर ई विल बी द एक्चुअल इनपुट सीन बाय द ट्रांजिस्टर, इज दैट क्लियर? वट डज दैट मीन्स? इनपुट रेजिस्टेंस इंक्रीजेज वेन एवर आर ई इज प्रेजेंट अनबाईपास्ड. कॉमन सोर्स और कॉमन एमिटर एम्पलीफायर विथ सोर्स डिजनरेशन और एमिटर ऑल्सो विल इंक्रीज आर आई, इज दैट करेक्ट? विल ऑल्सो इंक्रीज आर आई. सो वेन एवर देर इज ए सीरीज मिक्सिंग वेर द इनपुट वोल्टेज इज मॉडिफाइड बाय अनदर फीडबैक वोल्टेज, द रेजिस्टेंस एट द इनपुट विल ऑलवेज इंक्रीज. सो ये कहाँ जरूरी पड़ सकता है? वेयर डू यू नीड योर इनपुट इनपुट रेजिस्टेंस बी हायर? जनरली एम्पलीफायर्स हैव स्मॉलर आर जीरोज, इज दैट करेक्ट? नाउ इफ आई हैव ए स्मॉलर आर जीरो एंड आई एम फीडिंग इट टू ए नेक्स्ट स्टेज विच ऑल्सो हैज इक्वलेंट रेजिस्टेंस देयर, सो वॉट डज दैट मीन इन टर्म्स ऑफ मैथ्स? इफ आई एम हैविंग ए सर्किट हुज आर आउट ऑफ वन इज लोअर एंड आई हैव ए नेक्स्ट स्टेज हुज आर ओ टू इन, इफ दीज आर कंपेरेबल, part of the current is going here, part will go here, okay, what is it called? Essentially the node resistance will actually reduce and therefore the voltage at the input will not remain voltage which you are feeding, is that correct? So what should be ideally, RO2 should be much greater than RO1, then what will happen? All the current is only here, so this voltage remains constant, so the next stage sees same output of his first stage, otherwise it will get modified. And what does that word in other circuit be called? Loading. The next stage starts loading the first stage, is that correct? So abhi laga kya hai, to first stage amplifier ke baad bahut bar kya lagana padta hai next stage? Buffer. Buffer yani RE unbypassed or RS unbypassed, so uska input impedance beta times ya gain times input mein aayega. So it will be larger there, so any source now coming from there will not get modified for the next stage, is that point clear? That is why buffers are required, is that correct? What is the advantage of buffer other than the input resistance match? Its output is still low, okay. So if you have a circuit which requires load next, which is lower this, you have a RO lower, at the same time you are matching with the first stage, is that correct? That is why it is impedance transformer, as we can say, higher impedance connected to a lower impedance, is that correct? And what is the gain of a such stage normally buffers? Unity gains, because they are common emit source follower or emitter followers, okay, is that clear to you? Always a emitter follower or source follower is kept whenever impedance need to be matched between two individual stages, beech mein ek buffer dal do, okay, is that clear? So this is the technique we use everywhere, so this is why we say we want to reduce this effect of loading, we need to know some kind of impedance modifications, is that correct? In some circuit you may require RO reduction or RO increase, we can do all four, we can increase RI, decrease RI, increase RO, decrease RO, we are all possible. Oh, there is no hat, the hat was done here because you know you would ask is it VS here? This VS, okay, call it hat here, okay. No, actually we are not, what we are trying to say, whenever I calculate input impedance I do not consider real source and its series resistance, is that correct? So wahan phir bhi jo equivalent voltage aata hai wahi hum VS hat bol rahe hai, is that clear? I am not saying RS is 0 because that is something tomorrow will say sir aapne bola tha hamesha RS 0 hota hai, RS koi 0 nahi hota hai, source any signal source you put there is a series, I cannot avoid it, any voltage source will have a series resistance, is that clear? Low hoga, 50 ohm ho sakta hai, but hoga zarur, okay. The lowest is 50 ohms, okay. Okay. Okay, if I do shunt mixing at the input, please remember shunt, what kind of mixing can be done by shunt? Not by voltage, voltage cannot be shunt across. Ek voltage source ke across dusra voltage source dusra nahi laga sakte na. तो क्या शंट कर सकते हैं? करंट सोर्सेस, सो दिस इज माय करंट सोर्स आई एस एंड दिस इज द फीडबैक आई एफ एंड I am putting an RIF here, okay, and I want to know what is the RIF. Now I know IF is beta times x. Why I said x0 generally? Because I am now seeing either the at the output sampling can be voltage or sampling can be current, but that the input, it is always shunt. Is that word clear to you? Input is always shunt, but output is always can be voltage or series or shunt, either case. So maine dono ko ek mein mila diya. So is that point clear? It can be V0 or I0, either of them can be X0, but I have made a generalize this, okay. Because it doesn't matter, X0 aise bhi nikal jayega usme se, isliye it doesn't matter whether sampling was shunt or what we are looking essentially input side. Aapko input mein mix kya hota hai wo important hai, par gain ke liye aapko kuch number pata hona chahiye, okay. So X0 is A times II. Now as I say, it can be either of kinds, okay. What is II current? IS minus IF is II, which is entering RI. IS minus beta X0, IS minus A beta II, 1 plus A beta II is IS. So RIF is RI upon 1 plus A beta. Whenever I want to find an impedance, input impedance, what do I do in real life? I short all outputs, is that correct? I remove all independent sources other than the for which I am finding. That is the case I was solving. Is that clear to you? So, I as if Vx वहाँ लगा रहा हूँ और Ix ढूँढ रहा हूँ. किसी भी network का यदि input देखना है, तो मैं एक voltage source लगाया, एक current उसमें से निकला Vx by X. So that is what all that I am doing. Is that point clear? So वो Rs है कि नहीं, ये नहीं है. जहाँ मैं देख रहा हूँ वहाँ मैं अपना source लगाऊँगा, बाकी सब छोड़ दूँगा. Is that clear? So what is the disadvantage from this system or advantage? Isme RIF kam hua ya jyada hua? Kam ho gaya. Kyon hua? Ab currents ka ulta ho gaya actually. Is that clear? Because current is a feedback. The net current II essentially is reducing. II is sign wise if you see. That means V by II upon 1 plus beta, that means ye jo factor hai wo resistance ko utne ratio se kam karta chala gaya. Pehle isme kya kiya? Bada diya. Dusre mein kya kiya? Kam kar diya. Aisa hi hum output pe kar sakte hai kya? Us samay kya karenge? Input ko laga denge short, okay, aur output se dekhna shuru kar denge, usme loads hata denge. Is that clear? Loads are never considered in calculating output resistor. So here is one more case I will solve and will stop on this. I want to find shunt sampling. Let us say AXI is the gain. Again, what is XI? XI kya hoga ye? Input hai. Wo kya ho sakta hai? Voltage ho sakta hai ya current ho sakta hai. To dono ko generalize kar diya maine. Okay. AXI is the voltage which is appearing, AXI is anything, may plus minus abhi voltage equivalent source dikha diya. Uska series resistance jo is voltage source ka hai, wo hai R0, and this I now apply a Vx Ix. Vx is the source I applied the output and measure the current Ix. With feedback, Xi will be 0, input will be shorted. Is that correct? For output resistance, input kitna hoga? 0. So XI to 0 kar diya. XI 0 kiya hai ne, voltage 0 kiya ya current 0 kiya? No, no, because excess wo wahi par hai na, wo short hai uske across. So yadi usko short karte hain, to whatever resistance seen here is same as RO, okay. So no, without feedback, the output resistance is the RO of the source, RO of the source. But यदि feedback है, जैसा कि यहाँ है, अभी देखिए ROF is Vx by Ix, Xs is Xi plus Xf, अब X can be current or voltage whatever it is, with Xs equal to 0, you said it ना, Xs equal to 0, Xi minus is Xf, which means beta V0, so Xi is minus beta Vx, because V0 is same as Vx. So XI is minus beta Vx, substitute. What did I do? this is a shunt sampling going on, is that correct? So current voltage ko sample kiya gaya yahan par, is that correct? I applied a Vx source and I want to see what is the current coming out to get my resistance Vx by Ix. So I said at the input side I shunted the source, shorted the source, not shunted, short. So Xs is Xi plus Xf, Xs ko maine 0 kiya, so Xf is minus Xi, isn't it? But what is Xf? Beta times V0. Kitna feedback mila? Beta times V0. Ye voltage sample hai na? So beta times V0 is the voltage sample at the input as a feedback. So Xi is minus B, and V0 is how much? Vx. So Xi is minus beta Vx. Is that point clear? Phir se dekho. This is voltage which is same as Vx. Sampling is beta times V0, because it is a shunt sampled. Feedback is voltage now, beta V0. Equations mein input side mein dekhenge, to source plus is equal to Xi in the, at the input of the amplifier plus the feedback, is that correct? Abhi aapne expression dekhe na pehle. If Xs is 0, the feedback is opposite of Xi, but Xf is beta V0, so Xi is minus beta V0 or beta Vx. Xi is the input to the source. This amplifier mein ye jo yahan par jo bhi input aata hai usko Xi bolte hai, is that correct? Xs is here. So Xs mein kya ye voltage plus feedback, ye milke Xs hai na, ye voltage plus ye voltage is this voltage, is that clear? So that is the word which I have used there. Okay. So what is Xi? Minus beta Vx. So if I now say Ix, which is the current flowing here, is Vx plus A beta Vx by R0, which is my current now, is sade circuit se current nikalo. Ix is equal to Vx plus drop A beta Vx coming from here. Xi abhi hai na, abhi, what is Xi? Beta Vx, abhi nikala na, usko add karo sources ko. Vx plus A beta Vx divided by R0 is the current. Is that point clear? This voltage plus this voltage, yahan Vx hai, iske plus ye hai, divided by this current is the, by this resistance is the current. Is that correct? So Vx plus A beta Vx upon R0 is the Ix. So Vx by Ix is Ro upon 1 plus A beta. So it is Rof is 1 Ro by 1 plus T. So Ro bada ke kam hua, shunt sample mein kam ho gaya. So yadi Ro ko reduce karna chahte hain to kaun sa sampling hona chahiye? Shunt sampling hona chahiye. We didn't do it. Do it for the opposite case, second last case. I have a series sampling. Series mein kya sample hota hai? Current sample hota hai. By similar logic, if you solve that, you will get Rof is equal to how much? 1 plus A beta times R0. So the feedback output resistance is higher than the resistance with output resistance without feedback if you have a current sampling going on, is that correct? So now you have 4 cases: series mixing, shunt mixing, series sampling, shunt sampling. So now you could you get, I can get both lower, one higher, one lower, first lower, next higher, or both higher by a proper choice of mixing. Is that point clear? I repeat, since I have 4 amplifiers, I can increase Ri and increase Ro simultaneously. I can increase Ri but decrease Ro. I can decrease Ri, increase Ro, and I can increase both Ro and Ri. All 4 possibilities 4 amplifiers will give me. So whatever requirement I have in my actual requirement, I can choose one of the feedback blocks of that kind and I will use them in between to create the Ri and Ros of my choice. Is that clear? This is the advantage of feedback. That at what cost all that I am doing every time? The gain, gain ko chhoda hai maine. To ek baat circuit ka hai ya nature ka bhi hai ya apna human ka bhi hai. Na, linear system, mera to linear system mein pehle bata diya. The output grade is essentially proportional to your input work. Do whatever you say. Thank you very much.